Hello, here we are in the sacristy again, and I wanted to show you this poster here. It's an old poster. It's been hanging on my door to my bedroom for a long time, and it fell off the other day. The tape just gave way. I don't know what happened, but I'm gonna put it back up on my door, but it reminded me of my very, very good friend, Father Basil Nixon. He is a Benedictine monk in Norcia, Italy. And I met Father Basil 20 years ago. If you can imagine that, August of 2000. So we both entered the seminary at the same time, college seminary, and we were roommates the very first semester. And we were in school together studying philosophy for 3 years. His name wasn't Basil back then. His name was Michael. So Michael and I, we got to become really best friends. And our relationship, our friendship really deepened at the same time as, well, my friendship with Christ was truly deepening. The time in the seminary, as you can imagine, college seminary was very formative years. I got to know Jesus in a very beautiful, personal way. He became, well, a good friend. So my relationship with Michael, who's now Basil, my relationship with Michael and my relationship with Jesus really flourished in those years. Well, Michael, he did not go on to study to be a priest here in the United States. He went on to study to be a priest, a monk first, and then later on a priest in Italy, in Norcia, Italy, and he took on the religious name Basil. So it's interesting how we've maintained this friendship across an entire ocean. He occasionally will come to the United States, and I've been over to Italy, and we exchange emails, and we're able to talk on the phone, and just sharing life together, all the ups and the downs and all the good things and the bad things. And we're both priests, and we're both still sharing this friendship. It's a real blessing. I wanted to show you this poster because it has everything to do with what I'm talking about. This was the icon, this little image of Jesus that he chose when he made his final vows as a Benedictine monk. This is all the way back. This is Wednesday, August the 6th, 2008. And this is the poster that they hung up in the town of Norcia saying, everyone's invited to witness Brother Basil's final vows. In any event, he chose this icon. This is Jesus the friend. This is an ancient icon, centuries old, but it's really beautiful. There's Jesus here, and he's holding the book of the Gospels, and he has his arm extended in fraternity, in friendship to another monk right here. And I don't know, it just kind of captures, what does Jesus say at the Last Supper? This is John's Gospel, chapter 15. He says to the apostles, I call you my friends. And so, I hope we can all enjoy that friendship with Jesus. But how do you learn to be a friend of Jesus? It's actually in all of your other friendships, right? You have deep, lasting friendships with others, and you kind of get a taste of, oh, wow, this is what it means to have a deep, lasting friendship with Christ. So, this summer, I hope you're making time for friends, building up your friendships, and of course, we're all called to make time for our best friend, who is Christ the Lord.